Hello guys, Dr. Hasbullah here. I hope you already have some time to do and redo again the derivation that we have up until now. And in this video, we're going to continue what we do until we manage to find the drag force of laminar boundary layer profile. Let's carry on. So, what you need to do next is you will integrate these two equations. You integrate to the left and you integrate on the right. Okay, so this becomes del square over 2 equal to 10.8 nu over u infinity x. Okay, that's simple. So what we need now is del in the form of x. Okay, so keep del to the left and bring everything to the right. Okay, so that's going to be del square equal to 2 times 10.8. Okay, now we're going to do a little bit of manipulation so that we can get this equation as Reynolds number. I'll show you how. Okay, so Reynolds number is rho u x. So Reynolds number is rho u infinity x divided by mu. Okay, and if you use this equation, right, you can have Reynolds number x equal to u infinity x divided by nu. Okay, and we're going to see, because here we have this term, we have x, nu and u infinity. And we're going to see what to do with it, right, so that we can get it to group together and form Reynolds number term, right? So, it looks like we're going to need x at the bottom. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply this equation with x over x. Okay? And what this will do is that you're going to have nu x square over u infinity x. Right? Why did I do that? The reason I did that is because we can get here is actually 1 over Reynolds number, isn't it? Right? So we can make the equation prettier, right? And this becomes, if you take the square root of del, right? And you're going to have to square root everything, right? Okay, so in the end, you're going to end up with 4.65x divided by square root of Rex. Right, sorry, this is not del square, but this is just del. Right, and there we go. That is the relationship between del and x. Okay, but remember, our objective is not this. Our objective is actually to find the drag. And we know that in order to find drag, we need tau naught. Okay, but previously, we cannot use this directly, right? And we know that tau naught is actually this term, okay? But before, we cannot do this directly because we still have del, all right? Now, guess what? We already have del, okay? So now it's time to plug in the del that we found just now into this equation so that we can get tau, right? So let's do that, right? So tau is equal to 139 rho u infinity square d del over dx. Rho u infinity square d del over dx. Alright, remember that we already have del here. Okay, this is our del. But to solve this equation, I'm going to take del that has x in it, right? In this equation, we already convert some of the x into the Rex, okay? So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to take this equation, right, and put the del here, okay? Let's see what we can do about it, right? And this becomes 0.139 rho u infinity square d over dx, and del is 4.65 x over square root of RE X, right? And what do we do with this is that this is going to be 0.139 times 4.65 rho U infinity square D over DX, okay? X divide by, now we're going to dismantle the REX because we need to differentiate the X, right? So REX is actually U infinity times X divide by nu, and this is square root, okay? And let's take out U infinity and nu, take it out from the equation. Okay, and this is going to be 0.139 times 4.65, 0.646 rho U infinity square times nu over U infinity square root. This is D over DX, X to the power of half. Okay, and this is what we are going to differentiate. And this bit, of course, becomes half x to the power of minus half. Alright, and this is still 0.646 rho u infinity square, square root of nu over u infinity. Okay, so this becomes 0.323 rho u infinity square, and we can put this back to here, right? So that's become square root of REX again, right? So this is divided by square root of REX, right? And that's it, guys. That's basically the tau, okay? And when we have the tau, right, is not very difficult anymore to get the drag, alright? And usually tau, the unit for tau is Pascal, okay? But in order to normalize it, in order to make it non-dimensional, usually we're going to use something that is called local friction coefficient. Or CF, right? And CF is equal to tau divided by half rho u infinity square, right? And this makes it quite easy because we already have rho u infinity square on the other side of the equation. Okay, so this becomes 0.646 divided by square root of REX. Yeah, it's that simple. Okay, the final step is to find the drag force, right? So drag force FD, right, let me draw this to you. If you have the flat plate, right, and this plate has the length of L, okay, and what you want to do in order to get the drag for this plate is actually you want to integrate the wall shear stress over the distance, which is L, okay. So to put that mathematically, so the drag FD is equal to integration from 0 to L of the tau times dx, okay? And once you solve this, you can find the drag force. Okay, so our tau is from 0 to L, and our tau is 0.323 rho u square, 0.323 rho u infinity square divide by square root of REX. Okay, and once more, the X is actually inside this REX. So we're going to have to dismantle it in order to integrate the X. Alright, so we've done this before. So this is 0.323 rho u infinity square times, okay, so REX, okay, is actually square root of u infinity times x divided by nu. Okay, Okay, so this is going to be square root of nu divided by u infinity integration from 0 to L of x to the power of minus half. Alright, and when you find and when you finally get to this step, it's quite simple. So integration of x to the power of minus half will give you x to the power of half divided by 1 over 2. So 2 becomes on top, right? So 2 is now here. Okay, and this is from 0 to L. If we put L inside, you're going to end up with, right, 0.323 rho u infinity square nu over u infinity. This is going to be times 2L to the power of half. Okay, and this is going to be 0.646 rho u infinity square. Now, I'm going to try to squeeze this L into this term, right? So it gets to be Reynolds number. So what I need to do here is actually to multiply this with square root of L over L, right? And what that does is I'm going to have L at the top, and also I'm going to have square root of R E L. Okay, so sorry, let me put it this way. Okay, I'm going to have L at the top, and I'm going to have square root of U infinity L over nu. Okay, and this means you're going to end up with 0.646 rho U infinity square L divided by square root of R E L. Right, and there you go. And this is the drag force of the total length of your flat plate. Okay, and if you want to represent this non-dimensionally, okay, before this we have the CF, right, as a non-dimensional terms of wall shear stress. We also have the non-dimensional term for drag force, and that is called the skin friction coefficient. Right, and this is marked by CF, right? Remember, now this is C capital, F capital, right? So CF is drag force divided by half rho u infinity square L. Alright, now this is quite convenient, right? So this is simply 1.29 divided by R E L. And that is your skin friction coefficient. So let us recap what we have found. Okay, so we have found a few important and interesting parameters. Okay, we have found the skin friction coefficient, right? We have found the drag force, right? We have also found the tau, right? Or wall shear stress. We have also found the local friction coefficient, or CF. Right, we've also found the relationship between del to x, right, and finally we also know the relationship between theta to del. Okay, and all of this relationship is found based on our equation here, that is the cubic equation. Right, now I think you can imagine that if we have this relationship with cubic equation, of course, we are also going to have a relationship with quadratic equation, but the numbers here are going to be different. Okay, if you use the quadratic equation, the numbers here are going to be different. Right, doesn't mean it's wrong. Okay, this is the approximation of the actual solution. Okay, there is no way to know the actual solution unless we do the experiment. And someone else has conducted this experiment, and they found that the value here is still acceptable, which is within 7%, within 3% of the actual value. So it's quite a reasonable assumption that we have here. Okay, guys, so I think we've derived a lot of things today, and what I need you to do now is to derive it yourself. Okay, make sure you are comfortable doing this without seeing this video. But once you are comfortable doing this, then you can move forward to the next chapter or the next lesson. Now, just to recap, this is the drag force that you find if the flow is laminar. Right, you're going to find a different drag force if the flow is turbulent, which is what we are going to do in the next lesson. Right, but just like I said before, make sure you are already familiar with this before you move on to the next lesson. Alright, and just for your own fun, try to do this and find this relationship using the quadratic equation. Alright, so this is the hard part. Okay, the hard part, which is using cubic, I've already solved this for you. So how about you try and test your understanding by trying to find the CF, trying to find the tau, trying to find the skin friction coefficient, and trying to find the drag force for the equation from the quadratic equation. See if you can do it. If you can do it, then you can move on to the next lesson. Alright, thank you guys. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.